to my channel. I'm Ryan Elise, in case you're new. Today I'm just going to do a first impressions of two products from the same brand. They are JLV Cosmetics. And hold on, I gotta find it. I'm not organized at all. First one's going to be the Endless Glow. It's kind of like their Moonchild palette. And then I'm also going to do the first impressions on their contour kit. Both of these I found at... Both of these I found at Ross, but I will link the actual website down below in the description bar. So I'm not going to do a full face of makeup. I'm not really doing much but running errands, so I'm going to throw on some concealer so I can actually test what's going on with the highlighting colors. They do have several highlighting colors. I should probably tell you about the product first before I start just throwing on makeup, but I'm going to throw this on and then we're going to go from there. What did you guys think about my I'm back video? I tried to give as much possible information without, you know, overdoing it, but you know, that's life. I'm gonna look super pale today until I throw on that contour. I'm also gonna bronze my skin a little bit. Like I said, it's kind of wet here, if you can't tell by my hair. So we're just gonna go with it. How you like my shirt? Original fan, duh. My generation, and of course my fiance loves dress. Alright, so now that my concealer is in place, instead of using my usual Laura Mercier setting powder, I'm actually going to pull out the contour kit. It has the highlighting shade. I'm going to see how it does for setting my powder, and since I'm only doing concealer today, I figured, why the hell not? So, it does have two highlighting shades. It's got a nice little chart on the inside. It's got a pretty decent mirror. It's not like a funhouse mirror, so that's nice. I'm trying not to blind you guys. But these are the two highlighting shades, and then this is all the contour shades. I'm going to go ahead and use that kind of banana color because I'm pale right now. I will be posting on Monday. No, I'm sorry, Sunday. No, Monday. That's right, Monday. I will be posting on Monday my selfless / self-tanning routine. I'm going to pick up this brush. It's destroyed, but it's from Wish. I'm going to pick up some of that highlighting color. And just dust it under my eyes. But yeah, I'm gonna post that on Monday, so it's just in time for 4th of July weekend when I post it. Now, whether you watch it during that time, that's your business, but that's what I'm gonna go ahead and do for that. And I like how this is actually pretty highlighting to my face. Alright, so go ahead and to contour my face, I'm not gonna use this shrug brush today. I'm gonna use this one. I think I'm gonna pick up this color because I feel like this color is probably gonna look best on me, especially since I'm really fair right now. I'm not big on the ashy colors, so. All right, here comes the fun part. I'm gonna take these earrings out and put them back in. The bigger the hoop, the bigger the hoe. Just kidding. So I'm gonna go ahead and dust that on my face. My first impression of the contour is not too shabby. I'm really surprised. It's going on really smooth, and considering I don't have foundation or a lot of powder on, it's really nice. Okay. And I did get JLB Cosmetics, like I said, at Ross, and I believe this kit and this one were both $4.99 each. I'm not sure if that's what they retail for, but if I can, I will link that down below. So since I kind of messed this one up a little bit, I am going to clean up with the highlighting shade, and that's what I'm going to use that flat brush for, the e.l.f. flat brush. They are kind of powdery, I won't lie. But they are actually pretty decent. Disappointed. I mean, $4.99, that's not bad at all. And of course, I just cleaned that up and messed it up all in one time, so put my bronzer helmet on. Next, I am going to pick up on a fluffy brush. I think I'm just going to pick up one of these contour colors and throw it in my crease. I'm thinking that this color is the one I'm going to throw in my crease. It's more of an orangey peach color, and I think I'm just going to do it. It's just going to happen. We're just going to try it. I just want to try as many products as possible. And since this is more like, the Endless Glow is more like a Moonchild palette, I am going to probably go ahead and see how that works as well. Next on a fluffy brush, I'm going to put a little definition in my corner, so I'm going to use that contour color. Of course, there's no rule in makeup, duh, we already know this, but it's always nice to reiterate, because there's always somebody that's like, oh, you're not supposed to do that. I'm not doing full brows today either. I'm going to go ahead and just fill in some spots that don't need it. But I'm really impressed with this. It's not too, too choppy on me. It's nice. Okay. So, gotta put my earrings back in. I'm not really doing any blush today. I didn't put any primer on like a dummy. I didn't think about it, but it is what it is. My Anastasia, where'd it go? Okay, I lost my ABH brow definer. Oh god. Oh, where are you? I know you are here. Why am I singing to myself? I don't know. Oh god, I'm gonna lose my shit. I'm gonna lose my shit. I'm gonna lose my shit. Where'd it go? Ah ha ha! Oh, got stuck in my brushes. I was about to have a heart attack. I know I'm getting close to needing a new one, but I'm not okay with it. All I'm doing is running errands. Like, it's nothing too extensive. I just want to add a little definition to the face. So, now that's done. Okay. Next, I am going to actually do my highlight. This is a pretty quick, easy, simple thing. It's their Moonchild palette. It's actually really pretty. It's very, very dusty. I have swatched them. I mean, you can clearly see there's dust galore. Dust. You can clearly see they're very powdery. Like, it's all on the edges of my stuff. So, we're going to see how this goes. There is some glitter in them, so we're going to see how this works for me. I'm not the biggest fan of glitter. You guys know this. So, at least in my highlights. I mean, there's some that look glittery but don't transcend glittery. So, we're going to see. I'm actually going to swatch them on my arm for you. So first I'm going to start with Stellar. It's the orange color in the palette. I'm going to close that. As usual, there's plastic on it. So this is Stellar. Okay, you can't really see that on my skin tone, I don't think. I'm just too damn pale. So that's Stellar. Next is Stardust. Right here. It's the pink color in the palette. It does look, like I said, it looks glittery, but they all look glittery. They don't actually... I'm all over the place today. So, this is Dust. It's really pretty light pink. Okay, it's like a pink with silver glitters in it. So, there's glitter. I don't absolutely hate it. So, we're going to see how that goes. Next color I'm going to show you is going to be Moonbeam. I believe it's blue, but it might be more of a silver. So, we're gonna see. Okay, that's really, really gritty feeling, like choppy. Okay, there's a lot of kick up in these. For $4.99, like, can you really complain that much? Hey guys, so there will be a swatch photo at the end of the video so you can see what they look like, both wet and dry, because this was not a good representation. Blue silver. It's pretty. Next is Charmed. And this is what it looks like. Okay, that one's way more pigmented than the rest. Okay. Alright, there's that one. Then there is Aurora. Which looks like there's going to be a little more green in that one, actually, than the other one. My swatches suck today. And then there is Opal, and it looks like this is a duochrome. Let's swatch this one on my hand because I can't really read. So this is the... So I'm actually going to pick up probably... I think I'm going to pick up Aurora, that greener one right here, on a flat brush and throw that into the crease of my eye. Because I just want to test these for pigments and such. Okay, so that's two applications, and it's not exactly beaming, but I mean, maybe if you like a subtler highlight, you'll like it. Okay, it just looks like there's green light in my face. We're just gonna go with it today. I don't really care. Alright, and then on my face, I really want to try out that opal color because it's a duochrome pink purple color, so let me find. I'm just gonna use my massive fan brush. I'm just gonna highlight the face. Can you put pink on your nose? We're putting pink on our nose today. Okay, it does look a little pale on me. I don't know if it'll look different in the sunlight, but this is definitely a... Okay, we're gonna mix a little Stardust with that so it looks more like a blush, because that's a little too wet for mama. I will say that the highlights are definitely not something you can wear every day. They are chalky. And they are really powdery, I guess you could say. The colors are definitely not something you wear every day, but now there is the Moonchild palette from Anastasia. And for $4.99, I think this is pretty close to it. So if you're looking for a dupe for it, this is pretty close. But the formula's different, the colors are similar, but I mean, I'm not mad at it. It's not something I'd wear every day. This would be fun for like Halloween. But the contour kit, I love the variety in the colors. The highlighting powder is bomb for $4.99. It is a little powdery, obviously, like it's $4.99. You're not gonna go better than that. Now I don't know how much they retail for, so I will link that below. But I like the contour shade. I did pretty decently on my eyes. I'm not super upset about it, so yeah, first impressions are pretty damn good. Well, that completes this video. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video. Look for my self-tanner / sunless tanner routine. I'll be letting y'all know what I use in the video, as well as how I do it, and so on and so forth. Please excuse my bathroom when you watch it. Bye, guys!